a boy, I was singing. I like the lyrics from this song. This is the moment that I'm going to let my life flower. I'm going to let my life flower. So as we move into this new year, you know, actually, Glenda, every single point in your talk is a point in my talk. So, well, that's what happens. Truth is truth. Truth is truth. And when we've been together so long, we're kind of one mind. So I'm going to see what I can do to give you some different ideas and some different perspectives. The reason I picked this idea of this is the moment is because a lot of people that we communicate with on a regular basis, we get a lot of emails, get a lot of phone calls, that kind of thing, are telling us that they're purging, they're reorganizing, they're cleaning out closets, they're making lists for intentions for the coming year. So this is the time of year that we really start looking at what is the new me going to look like Linda said, you know? Some people go into dieting, or they go into exercising, or they go into, you know, going to take that art class, or whatever that thing is. Sort of the new. We've got to start the new. And as I was working with this, I thought, well, wait a minute, there's really nothing wrong with me. My old self. There's nothing wrong with the old me. There's nothing wrong with us. So that's the truth. There is nothing wrong with us. We're always and already this incredible energy of the divine expressing. That's what we teach, and that's what we invite you to understand and believe about your own journey. Now, my essential self doesn't need any refinement. It's brilliant. It wears that halo, and it knows exactly how to be present in the world in this radiant way. However, my human self, well, my human self needs a little tune-up every once in a while. My human self, like Linda was talking about the gems that need to be polished, my human self needs some refinement from time to time. And so this idea of embracing that human part of ourselves this time of year, examining it, looking at it, going, where do I need to make some refinements here? Where can I polish some of these rough edges? This is really an important practice, and the first of the year is a perfect time to get started. This is the moment to get that kind of energy rolling. Because we're so distracted, we are coming out of the big holiday season, yes. We've been busy and, you know, eating and cooking and partying and visiting and doing all the things that we do in the holidays, and this is kind of a downtime. One of the individuals that I email with on a frequent basis said, you know, this feels flat. This feels kind of like dead energy right now. All the sparkle, I took my tree down and the sparkle's gone. Anybody relate to that? You know, sort of it's starting to be like winter again. So this is a perfect time for us to sort of come in and live this examined life that Glenda was talking about and look at those areas that might need some modification. So, I didn't bring my laundry, but I did bring something to share with you this morning. I'm going to try to do this. These are the prayer flags from my backyard. And as I was working on my talk concepts, I looked up and I saw these tattered, torn prayer flags in my backyard. I've got a whole bunch of them. And I knew that when the new year, on New Year's Day, that I was going to replace the tattered, torn prayer flags with new prayer flags. And I thought, ooh, there's a message there. Because I was thinking about myself and some of the people that I know, some of the situations on the planet, some of the circumstances in the news look like this prayer flag. Look a little tattered, look a little worn out, look a little faded, look a little ragged around the edges. And I was thinking, in some areas of my own life, I have those same feelings, that sort of raggedy, tattered sort of feeling. Now, yesterday when I hung up my new flags that my beautiful husband Dennis helped me, look at them. They're vibrant, they're colorful, they've got full promise, they're all crisp, and they're ready, but you know what? Within the next 12 months, they're going to look like that. And so the reason that I chose this as a metaphor is because those prayer flags did their job, just like we do our job. We become the container for the wind to blow through, to set the prayers, you know, out into motion, to let the energy of the divine go forward. And after a while, we need to regroup, and it's not that we replace ourselves, it's that we bring in new qualities, we bring in new life, we bring in new vibrancy, we bring in the fresh and the sort of new perspectives. We bring in the new prayer flags to get ready for the next year, because you know what? We're going to need a lot of prayers, aren't we? We're going to need a lot of prayers. So this idea of we honor what happened, we bless that, we retire those old ways of being and seeing the world, those old perceptions, and now we bring on the new. We bring ourselves back to life this time of year. This is the moment to do that. And we allow ourselves to start unfolding now in the present moment, you see. Because we can't do it later. We start now. We do it now. And for me, I kind of looked at that and I thought, you know what? This is it. This is my life today. This is my opportunity today. It's been a crazy year. It's been a crazy life. But I get this opportunity in precious human birth to make a difference in the world. That's my job. My job is to live from that vibrant place, that comfortable place, that place that allows the divine to blow through me and send those prayers out into the world in a vibrant way. And so I gotta make it count. I only get one chance this time around in this particular people suit, and I wanna make it count. I wanna make it count. I wanna make a difference in my journey, my spiritual journey. This is it. So I wanna jump on board with my life experience. And part of that is I've got to be able to take a look at what's not working for me, what's holding me back, what's getting in the way, and I've got to be willing then to see that thing with new eyes, whatever that is. Exactly the same things Glenda talked about. How am I going to see that? Because I love what Marianne Williamson says. She says, when I'm at the effect of the problem, I become part of the problem. So when I'm at the effect of all the stuff going on in the world and my own life and all the crazy, I'm at that effect. But when I'm centered in the truth of my being, when I'm reflective, when I know who I am, when I pay attention to the energy of the divine within me and that it's my great gift to bring that forth in my humanity, guess what? I become part of the solution. I become part of the solution in my own journey and in everybody else's, because I become a radiating field of energy that sends itself out into the universe in a positive way to help counterbalance some of that negative, icky stuff that's out there. Feels kind of dense out there this time of year, doesn't it? Feels kind of dense when we look at the news. Feels kind of dense when we look at some of our relationships. My invitation is to start looking at that and make that choice that Glenda talked about, to renew and to refresh, to add vibrancy, to add life to that thing. And the way we do that is to remember what Eric Butterworth says. If I don't like the way my life's going, if it feels flat, if it feels gray, if it feels purposeless, guess what? If I'm not happy with it, it's my job to say, hey, this is my life, I'm gonna turn it around. I'm not this pile of tattered and torn prayer flags. I'm going to add vibrancy and I'm going to renew this experience. I get to make a change, you see. Because if I don't change the way I relate to life and to others and to this world, when it's, you know, feeling difficult for me, or when I see anger, or when I feel worry, or when I'm in fear, or when I'm in judgment, or when I don't forgive, whatever those things are, if I don't change those perceptions, my experience is going to reflect all those qualities. If I want to have a beautiful experience, I got to bring beautiful qualities into the experience. The time to reorient myself is right now. This is the moment. This is the moment. This is the now moment. And this is the thing. It's not that I'm going to avoid all the stuff in my life. Anybody not got stuff? There's stuff. There's that dirt cloth that Glenda was talking about that she dug up in that pile of mound of dirt. See, there's stuff There's issues. We're not going to move around it, but what we can do is we can transform that. Be ye renewed by the way your mind perceives the experience. Your thoughts have a lot to do with that, you see. To say goodbye to all that unskillful stuff that's been holding us back, so that we can say hello to those new vibrant qualities. Because what I know is, the way I think about things has a lot to do with the way my life shows up. And if I'm thinking negatively, guess what I get back? If I'm thinking worried thoughts, guess what I get back? If I'm thinking angry thoughts, guess what I get back? On New Year's Eve, we had the burning bowl, and we all had an opportunity to write something on a special magic piece of paper that we put into the flame, and it evaporated, and some flew up, and some just sort of smoldered. But I had a real stumbling block this past, well, almost 2 years now, that I've talked about from this platform. And I put that name on that piece of paper, and I let that thing go, and it burned up, and there it went. And you know what? Just the willingness to put that thing in writing and to offer it to the transformative flame of that New Year's Eve fire has started to shift some of my anger. Do you understand what I'm saying? Has started to revitalize that place within me that can find acceptance. Still not there 100%, but I'm working on it, see? I get to work on it. I get to live and examine life, take inventory, find those places in myself, pay attention to how I perceive the world and my place in it, give meaning to it, you see, and see, what am I missing? Where do I need to make adjustments? What do I need to change here? If my current view isn't that of love and kindness and a sense of well-being and peacefulness, I better look at that thing and find out what are the possibilities within that thing as it is that I can take from that so that I can live the qualities that I want to live in my life. Choose a new way to see and choose a new way to be. It's just that simple. Now, but it's not easy. It's not easy. It's a simple concept, but it takes courage, it takes bravery to allow the feelings to move through, those feelings of anger and resentment and non-forgiveness. You've got to let that stuff move through you, like Carol would say, and then embrace all of it and embrace that part of ourselves where we feel like a failure because we can't let that person go. We feel like a failure because we can't let that relationship go. We feel like a failure because we can't let that grief go. Whatever that thing is, that fear around our economy or whatever, we just embrace that, embrace all the goof-ups of life where we feel like we've made a failure. And then remember that the only failure that we can ever have is the failure to grow through what we've experienced. Embrace it, move through it, and let it teach us the lesson and get over it, you see. So when we can do that, we grow in peace of mind, we grow in freedom, we grow in a sense of deep ease around our life experience, and then this new me, this new vibrant, colorful, beautiful, crisp, lovely me shines through in a way that it couldn't before, see. So I pick this image, the radiance within, see. It's there, I just gotta let it out. It's there, I just have to make that space for God so that it can come out. Here's your invitation. Remember, there's nothing wrong with you. There is nothing wrong with you. You are perfect and whole. Your essential self, your divine self, nothing can ever change that. And you're human. And so your human self probably needs a little adjustment. Your human self probably needs a few little corrections, just like mine. So if your life isn't happy, if you don't like what life is showing you, guess what? You get to turn it around. It's your life. Nobody can do it for you. Jump on board. Choose a solution that works for you. Choose a way to add that vibrancy, that life, that color back into your life. Have the courage to make those changes. Bless your goof-ups. Learn from them and move on. And remember those lyrics that Susan Boyle sang. This is the moment. If not this moment, when? What are you waiting for? This is the moment to address all of that stuff that's gotten in the way of your vibrant way to be present in the world. Thanks for listening.